Welcome back, guys, and do a gear review today. It's gonna be fun. So let's get started, man. Let's get with it. Welcome to my 2023 DRZ Cross Country Adventure. So we're going to start today with the gear review. Got a couple of things first I want to go through. First thing I want to do is look at the bike, show you what I got going on with that, and then swapping out some GPX routes. I think it's going to be interesting, and we'll get to that in a minute. But first of all, let's take a look at the bike. This is a 2020. DRZ. I have 21,000 miles on it, and basically the changes I've done on this bike since the first trip, new stator, rectifier, basically that's it. The brakes, oil, radiator flush, maintenance stuff. I'm running the same setup because it worked so well in 2020. Hey man, we're great in 2021. Why not do it now? So, Altrider. Altrider, and the reason I like Altrider is I just loosen these up here, unbuckle those. Just pulls right out of the saddle. I can leave the saddle on the bike, and I do full time. I can use it for carrying whatever I want. And then when I go on my adventure trips, put the gear back in the saddle. Looks fine. This year I'm doing something a little different. Got rid of the, Rotopack water. Got rid of that. Talking to Frostbite Venny, turned me on to another product. I forgot the name. I'll show you though. Oh yeah, Cactus Canteen. This is a 1 gallon. Collapsible drinking water, and this is going to be a lot easier to carry than hauling around that roto pack, man. I think it was terrible. Anyway, so I installed this. Let me go over that. We're going to make a loop around the bike. So anyways, what I did here, look, some of these routes I'm going to be are not Transamerica Trail, BDRs, things like that. If you have issues, there's a good chance somebody would come along, hopefully. But some of the routes I'm going through, I'm on my own. So let's continue around. Part of my gear review, I'll go through this and my cameras. I just want to concentrate on the bike. Stock sprocket, original chain. I switched up on the rig gear. I went to a bigger tank bag. The one I had before was too small. And this thing holds a lot. So, and it's expandable. I mean, the thing will come up a lot higher if I need it, but so far, things seem to fit okay. So, it's helping a lot. I've got bear spray. And what I did with the bear spray This is the original bear spray I bought for 2021. I already ordered, I'm gonna upgrade, get a new canister, and slide that in the holster. I mean, why not? You know, I didn't use it then, probably never use it, but it's there. Running two GPS, I've got the XT and the 396. I love the XT. I've got the same 4 gallon IMS fuel tank, engine guards, basically set up the same. Stacks, jetting on the carburetor. And I had no trouble with that when I was up 13,000 at Imogene Pass. So yeah, it works fine. Running running spots, which are really cool. Got them wired up the same way. They work great, and I have no issues with this at all. I've had no issues with the electrical on this bike at all. The way it's wired up, it's worked fine. Dash cams front and back. Yeah, I'm going to do it again. But, so, they are on. So we'll see how well that works. This turns off the 396 GPS. One of them is just white, doesn't do anything. I'm running 606 tires, and the way it's looking, I don't know. I might in Moab, so I have to swap them out. It might be the last chance as I get up into northern Utah and then to Wyoming, so we'll see. Now, I'm considering, I've already purchased some. I've got extra handles, clutch and brake. It's a crapshoot if I take them or not. I might wire them up here and zip tie them on. I've got a cable. You know, typically when your cable is going bad, it's going to go bad at this bend up here. And it'll start fraying on you. And my cable seems to be pretty good, but I could pre-wire a clutch cable in there. I don't know. I'll see what happens with that. I'm going to take extra fuel. Never use these. I've got two of them, one on each side. I've never got to the point where I ran out of fuel and I needed them, but it's not a bad idea. So I will, when it's necessary, I will pop those off. Let's see what else. There's the dash cam rear camera for those unexpected videos. Yeah, we'll see about that. Right here. Basically, that's it. It's the same setup. I'm going to put an inline fuel filter before I leave, change the oil. Basically, I'm good to go. Just a chain, maybe, clean it. So that is the bike. Let's go back over here. Let's take a look at the changes in the routes. Now, these are all options. And we'll see what happens when they get there. You know, rain plays a lot into these trails. Depends on the ground, depends on the mud. Some mud's stickier, it's all over. And it just depends on what's going on when I'm at that particular place at that particular time. So I want to go through in Utah. I want to go through you know the place I'm talking about. Man, why can't I remember? What's going on is I'm scheduled for an MRI. Hey man, this time it's the left shoulder. But as soon as I get that MRI and I get back to see my surgeon, next day, man, I'm hitting the trail. I got a buddy, Frostbite Vinny. Guys, go to his site, man, check him out. I'll leave a link below. He's got a GPX route that I'm highly interested in, and I'm gonna go for it. So I'll be one of the first guys to do his route. It's gonna be interesting, because as you see, it's a lot of double track, and you're out in the middle of nowhere, very few gas stations. We'll see what happens. Also, I threw a couple of my own routes in there. Minnesota, Wisconsin, Upper Peninsula of Michigan, Lower Peninsula of Michigan. I have got some routes that I would like to do that I turned into tracks, and I'm gonna go for it, see what happens. The heck, what are you doing, you idiot? You almost hit me in the head. Reindeer, pants, sure, jacket. Honestly, I think it was Rocky Mountain. I purchased these through. Anyways, next item is my tent. I've been using a tarp tent for years. I mean, I've had this tarp tent. Not this one, it's a new one. I've had this tarp tent through so many different trips, adventures, situations, and the zippers finally just blew out on me. So I ordered a new one. I love tarp tent, never failed me. I'll set this up later, I'll show it to you. This is not my rain tent. That is my luggage, which fits. It fits into this holster. I leave the holster on the bike full time, and makes it easy just to pull everything out one time to slide it back in. We'll go over some more of that in a minute. Anyways, sitting back over here. These are clothes items. We'll go through that in a minute. Sleeping bag, it's probably rated to maybe 30. If it gets colder than that, I'll just put some clothes on, layer, but I've had this for years, works fine. A lot of this gear, there's no reason to replace it. my armor, which I love. I wear this all the time I'm on dirt, on the trails. This has saved me so many times. So, and I can wear it by itself, or I can wear it over something like what I've got on now. It's a necessity for me. Some guys, some of you guys have coats with armor in them, but I like this. My tools. Got my shorties in here. You remember the shorties? Back from the 2021 ride. I love these wrenches. These things are so cool. And that's not one of them. I'm so short I can't find them. Here they are. Shorties. Easier to carry. I love them. Anyways, sockets, odds and ends in there. My slime, my little mini compressor, and inside here I have some tire patch glue and patches and stuff. So I will not be hopefully patching tires because I'm probably not very good at it. I never had to do it yet. I've only had one flat tire. One flat tire in Oregon and 2021 part 35. I'm guessing. I don't know. But so I had the 21 front. Then I put it in the 18 rear and it worked fine. So next. And these are all out of order. I'm just throwing them out there. Shower wipes. If you notice, they are dude wipes. Women can't use these, you know, they're only for dudes. Round cloth. I like the Tyvek. This is so old that it's finally worn in. I mean, it's more of a cloth material. It's not as paperish. It doesn't rattle so much anymore. But I may replace it this time. I ordered a small tarp. And these are my poles. I keep them inside here to protect them. But the tarp I'm thinking is I'm expecting a little more rain out of this trip. I think it's going to be a little more problematic. I'm going to be prepared for it. So the tent basically, the tarp basically will attach to the bike, hang down and stake to the ground, and it'll be something I can get out of the rain on the trail or on the road or wherever. And then I can also use it under the tent when I'm camping. So it has a dual purpose use. I can't do that with the Tyvek. The Tyvek doesn't have the grommet holes on. I will be wearing my lit X-Brace. I got that snap PCL. I worry about my knee twisting, so this has been something I've used for your last couple of rides. I really enjoy it. Seems to be effective and it doesn't seem to hinder me, my movement. Frostbite Benny turned me onto this, so I don't need my rotor pack no more. Carries a gallon of water, straps about anywhere.
Can't beat it, man.
Cactus Canteen. Yep. I forget what's in here. My pocket rocket. My coffee cup. My little portable stove. Butane, propane, propane. And I got a canister of that in here. Come out of there. Fuel cartridge and my coffee cup in here to boil water. I gotta have coffee, guys. I have to yet pick up some coffee though, but believe me, I will. Okay, I got stuff scattered, so bear with me. My helmet, same as always. I forgot what it was, but I'm running a GoPro 10, and it does the job. I like the chin mount. I don't like the side mount. I don't like the top mount. I like the chin mount. I like that view better. I'm running my microphone underneath, inside there. So this has been effective. It looks fine for me. Gotta have flip flops. I'm running these boots are crazy cool. Okay. These things are still my favorite item of all my purchases for this ride and all the other rides. This is the Formal Low. And man, are they broken in now, but oh, these babies are great. They're lugged. Yeah, they're my favorite. Battleborn Gray, going back to the 2020 ride at the gray on that. I went to 2021, I went black. I'm going back to the gray, and the reason is, check that out. Am I color coordinated? Hey, when you're on the trail, you gotta look good, you know? So I got these new Tsudishi gloves. My old ones wore out so bad I couldn't wear them no more. But I really like them. So they match the Battleborn. I would be running a couple of tight shirts because then I could layer over them, especially if I want armor. Let's see what else. Flashlight cheapie. Guys want to see? I checked it out. Pretty cool, huh? Flashlight. Chain lube. Yep, gotta have that. My second GoPro 10. One is chin mounted on the helmet. You know, the one for handlebars, wherever, you know. Also, I'm running two 360s, as you can see. I'm got them going right now, so. And my can of beer, which is optional. Anyways, I'm debating about these steaks. I really like these. I've used these on the last couple of trips. They don't bend. Some surfaces you're on, it's so rocky. I mean, it's just, I get those cheaper steaks, and I think I might be able to show them to you. But it's a trade-off because of the weight of these, so I'm not sure. I haven't made up my mind yet what I'm going to do with that, but I only need two of them. And later on, when I put the tent up, you know, I'll show you that. So check this out, guys. And let me bring you a little closer. This is a little bit different here. What I did is, I bought this cheap case, right, top case. Because I don't have my rotor pack no more. I got the room, and what the heck. I'm going to be on some routes that I'm not going to be crossing paths with anybody. Some of these routes, like especially frostbites out there in South Dakota, I don't expect to see a soul out there. And it's going to be a long stretch of gas station. It's just going to be a little risky for me. I don't do satellite in reach spot. I don't do any of that. So what I did, and I know I had a hard time doing this, but I went with an extra battery. That adds so much weight. Now I'm basically running almost the same weight as before on my other trips, except for this battery and this Anker power bank, which I love. I will be using it quite often. It's worth it, but man, it's heavy. My Climate Static V, I went with a new pad, a little bit bigger. You know, it's a toss up there. So, I figure, why not, you know? There's that. This is this is a little different here too. Check this out. I mean, I got a little crazy with the SD cards. Guys, I ran out once when I was in Dalton, Georgia. I had to go buy a bunch. Cost me a fortune. So I've got, as you can see, 3, 6, 9, 18 there, and they're mixed up. I got a couple. I got 164, some 32s. I got mostly 128s and 256 cards. So I got plenty. And I even got more. So I got three here, four, got four more here. So that's my empty SD cards. And something else, my routes. I have a collection of routes, and I have backups for all of them because I'm running two GPS. If something goes wrong with one, I want to have a backup. So if I remember where they are, underneath, I've got an Arizona BDR and I have an Arizona BAT. So that's my backups there. And then as we move on, I have a Utah BDR and a Utah BAT. Wyoming, Transamerica Trail. I have to do a backup yet. I'll get another card and make another copy for that because I want two of everything. South Dakota, these both have Frostbite Vinny's routes on them. And I'm looking forward to doing that route. I tell you, that's going to be one of the highlights of my trip. It's going to be interesting. This is Minnesota. I have to make a second with that. Oh, by the way, I've got 2 weeks. Here's the deal with when I'm leaving. I went in to see the surgeon yesterday because obviously I got the right shoulder done. If you guys know me at all, I've been through that. That's why I missed last year's ride. I totally missed last year because I had surgery in June. I ended up doing the cave. It's kind of crazy because I shouldn't have been riding my bike, but I couldn't stay off, man. And if you check out this video here, it'll show you. I lost a lot of weight, and yeah, that rehab was tough on me, but so check out this video here and you'll see what I'm talking about. So moving on to the next SD cards for tracks. I've got the Minnesota, which is my route. A little mixed up there. I did the best I could with it. It's sporadic. I might fill it in, see if I like it or not. I got some options on that too. In case one doesn't work out, I can option over to another. That's not in the video, but it'll be on the GPS. I've got two of those. And so these are in order of the states I'm going through. Michigan. I have two Michigan SD cards for the Upper Peninsula, which include the Lower Peninsula. When I leave Michigan, then I've got to route myself down to Mississippi. I'm just going to go south. I'm going to go across the Ohio River, head south, jump on the Mississippi Tat, and so I've got two of those. That will lead me through, obviously, Mississippi, Arkansas, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Colorado, till I hit Trinidad. And then I've got other plans after that. Here's another thought on my return trip is the New Mexico BDR south and connect with the International Continental Divide route from Kevin. I'll have to wait and see what happens at the time if I want to continue on the Transamerica Trail through Colorado, but that's been done. And I think the BDR in New Mexico might be interesting. I'd have to stay with the Kevin's route though, because it'll take me to my destination, which is Antelope Wells at the border of Mexico. So let's take another look from another angle. So coming out of Trinidad, and of course this is looking south, I would have to make my way and route my way through roads. There's no trail, no connecting trails here, so I'd have to take roads and catch the New Mexico BDR at its furthest northern point. And that'll be fun. It looks like an interesting trip. It's a great option. Again, I have the options of going back and forth between the ICBR and the New Mexico BDR. So, and the New Mexico BDR splits off here and heads quite a bit east, puts me way out of my my design location where I want to end, which is at the border of Mexico at Antelope Wells. So that's kind of another option. Again, you can look at my full route with the link below. This is another Tat. I think two of them are Kevin's and one of them is a Tat Sam. And then I have the International Continental Divide, which leads actually from the Northern Canada all the way down to Southern Mexico. But I've got the, I only purchased the United States section of the International Continental Divide. So I'll be jumping on that in New Mexico. You'll see in the video. And that's basically it. But I've got a stash of these SD cards, so it's cool. I'm ready to do like tens and hours and editing forever. It'd be like 30 parts to my next series. Anyways, that is there. You guys know what this is if you have a GoPro. It's my audio backup. Plenty of these. Lens wipes. Believe me, I'll burn through all of them. So that's kind of it in this box. And for now, I'll tuck this into here. A little bit of GoPro accessories. I still got to pick up a few things. I'm testing out today. That's kind of what's going on. Let's see what I might need yet. So, a couple of weeks, like I always say, it depends on the surgeon. And I kind of lost track on that. But the I went in for consultation with my surgeon, which we're starting to know each other pretty good now. And I got a problem with that left shoulder. I did damage after the 2020 ride, after that ride was complete. It wasn't long, a month or so after, I did some major damage. Rotator cuff, never got it repaired. It kind of wove itself back together. It took like a long time, 6-8 months, man. I was struggling. And now over the course of events, I find that I'm re-ripping that. So I'm getting an MRI. I'm waiting for the insurance to come in on that, get everything cleared up, do the MRI, and then consultation with him again. I want to make sure I know what's going on. If there's surgery going to happen, I want to make sure I schedule it for October 1st when I come back. And but it's not going to hinder me any. With my armor on, there's only certain movements that really hurt. Getting old. What can I say? So my date of departure could vary a little bit. I thought the 23rd, it was in the 16th, now it might be the 23rd. I'm not sure yet. I'll just have to see how that plays out for me. So toiletries. Razor, toothbrush. I'm not taking toothpaste. I take these little packets of salt. I don't want to take toothpaste because it is like really yummy for the bears. And so I brush my teeth with salt and water. It's just me. Now I said I wasn't going to do this, but I decided to go for it. Yeah, Dan's doing the drone. This is something that is, again, adding a little bit more weight to the bike. This is a fairly good size, strong. EXO Cinemaster, most people want a smaller drone. I thought about ordering another one. And I had trouble with EXO. If you look at my EXO videos, you'll see what I had to go through. But in the long run, I've had this a while now, this has turned out to be a really good drone. But it's heavy. It's really heavy. But there's a purpose for it. I'm going to have some fun with it. And charging batteries is going to be a little aggravating, but yeah, whatever. You just gotta do what you gotta do. Controller. Extra battery for the drone. This is for the 360 batteries. I'm doing a recorder. Really like this Tascam. So when it comes occasionally, have some fun with this. And I've got, here, let's go over and get the other camera. I think we need to shut one of these down. Well, that's it, guys. That wraps it up. We're going to do a little night lapse over here. Let's see how that works out. I haven't done it before, so I like learning new things. I'll throw it out there and see what happens with it. If you guys don't see it, it's because I screwed it up. Hey, beat shoveling horseshit, right? Right? What? You shut up. Come on. Anyways, we're going to make new friends. We're going to visit old friends. Yeah, and we'll have a good time. No matter where you're at, what you're doing on the trail, it's always a good time. So we'll see you guys in September, and we'll see how this whole trip turned out. All right, we'll see you then. Thank you.